We have here Dominika. She comes from Slovakia, where her journey actually as a yoga instructor started 8 years ago during her studies. So in case you're guys studying now, maybe this is the perfect time to start doing something that you really love. After her studies, Dominika wanted to find new opportunities for self-development. And that's why Udomi moved to Germany, right? And that's also where you had your first yoga training in Berlin. And right now you live in Vienna. You are actually working full time as in an IT industry, but still you do basically yoga or hot yoga to kind of find your daily balance. And you can find her in a yoga studio in the heart of Vienna, where she teaches basically in 37 degrees hot yoga. And with that, basically, I would like to give you stage, Domi, now, or maybe I should say Matt, and everybody just enjoy the session. I hope you will have a lot of fun. And yeah, feel free to answer or ask questions then at the end of the session. So Domi, the stage is yours.
So hello, everyone. Thank you for the word. And I'm very happy that you are joining this webinar. That we are going through a little yoga session together, and I'm very happy that Monchi Pirates also gave me this opportunity. As I could read already in the chat, there are some people joining us only watching today. It's no problem. You are welcome also just to sit and to watch. You are not forced to do everything what we are going to practice. Maybe you just get motivated for the beginning, and by the next webinars, you are going to use your mat and your sporting clothes also. So for the beginning, as you could see in the description, I would like to maybe introduce the yoga, what is it, and why it's so popular in the world right now. Definitely, you can see in your every day, everywhere in the magazine, in the TV, everywhere where you go, when you travel, a lot of yoga studios, they are everywhere around us. It really booms nowadays. And I see it as a really positive thing. Maybe first we can look at it from that physical part. People, they really love to practice it as all the other kind of sports, because they get fit. They feel better, they get to know their body a little bit better, they get stretched, and maybe they also strengthen their muscles. And it might have also some negative impacts, which I don't really like when people, they talk about it, that now you can really see it everywhere, like also on the Facebook and Instagram, that it's like kind of style of people's life. I see it very positive, because even if you do yoga only just to have nice pictures, because you manage some great position and you get more flexible and you want to show it to your friends, it's okay, because you might motivate your neighbors, your friends, other people, they follow you. So I prefer it. I like it. It's nice. We live in these times, and especially in this situation where we are right now with the corona situation. We live in times where technology and social media are really important. And if we can spread what we like, what we are joining to the other people, it's very nice to motivate also others. From the other point of view, some people, they might practice yoga, and their surrounding don't even realize it. They don't have to know about it, because they prefer to joining the yoga from more from the emotional part. So during their practice, they don't have to also make some difficult positions. You can go through some yin positions when you stay in your position for a few minutes, and you really go deep into yourself. You listen to your heart, you listen what's going on in your head, what questions are coming out in your head, and this is the great connection of your mind with your body. And that's why also I love to practice yoga. I started with that, as Annette already mentioned, 8 years ago during my studies, because many of you, maybe being now on university, or even if you are already working and having families, you might come into some situations when you sometimes don't find the right way, like where should I go if the way I'm going is all right. So I think this is the time on your yoga mat to calm your mind a little bit down and to be aware of everything what's going on inside of you. And why we connected with all that physical practice, with all the positions, and why we are doing all the positions. On the first time, it's, yes, your fitness, you want to feel well. On the other side, maybe this is the way which allows you to let go all the emotions. When you come to positions, there are like, for women especially, it's famous that all our emotional stuff, they are saved in our pelvis. So that's why the hip opening positions, for example, are very important for us, where we go deeper in the position and some emotions come on the surface and we might find a way we cannot find in our lives. So enough of the philosophy, I think. Another point we had, I wanted to answer that point that yoga is for everyone. In my life, I met so many people, they thought like, no, I'm not going to practice yoga, I cannot even try it, I have seen it in a video, and all people, they look like great, they're perfect, flexible, they can do it perfectly, I would never manage it. So we as human beings, we are all different, and that's beautiful about yoga, that everyone can find from here for himself what does great for him. So when you come on your mat, even when you're in a yoga studio full of 20 people, and you see that your neighbor can do something more, what you maybe don't manage, it's okay, because we are everyone on different level and exactly there where we need to be. So even if you are on the beginning of your yoga practice, and maybe this is the perfect moment that you are at home, in your living room, you feel relaxed now, no one is watching you. And even if you decided just to watch this session today, maybe you still might rethink it to get on your sporting clothes and to start to move a little bit and to look how does it influence your body, how does it feel for you, and to find your own way into every yoga position. And you are also welcome to stay in every position as long as you need. So yoga is really for everyone, especially the people which doesn't do it, they need it the most. Even if you do other sports, it's perfect to some like to supplement it to get better. If you are doing some running sports or swimming and you get more stretch, you can see then in the future that in your favorite sport you're going to get better because also of that flexibility. So welcome to my class. We are going to go to practical part, and for that I hope that you have already your sporting clothes on, you have prepared your yoga mat. Maybe you can put on some music. I couldn't use the music because I wasn't sure how you are going to hear me, if it's going to work together, also talking and playing the music. So you are welcome to also play some chilling music in your room and let's start together. I will meet you in 2 minutes on yoga mat. I'm back on the yoga mat. We are going to start in a cross-legged position. If this doesn't feel comfortable for you, you are also welcome to take a blanket if you have at home next to you or some pillow and to put it under your hips. You can sit down on your blanket so your hips get a little bit higher, and then you can relax also your hips and hips joints and your knees. For the beginning, bring your arms on your knees. Keep your shoulders relaxed, stack your belly in, plug your belly in, and your shoulder blades are working towards each other. Shoulder relax towards your mat, and close your eyes for a while. make sure that your chin is also coming towards your chest slightly, and your neck is long. Your neck is in the same line as your whole spine. Your elbows are relaxed a little bit. And connect yourself with the breathing. First, deep inhale, open up your lungs, and push your belly button forward towards the camera, towards me. And then we deeply exhale, relax your shoulders, and plug your belly button in again. One more time, deep inhale, open up your heart, your lungs, and then fully exhale, relax your shoulders. One more time, deep inhale, and fully exhale, relax everything on your body, relax your knees, your hips, and bring your chin on your chest, relax your head forward. And now you can feel the first stretch in the back part of your neck. A little bit start to play with your head. Rotate your head to the left and right side. Bring your ear, your right ear to your right shoulder and left ear towards your left shoulder. We will start with a little half circles with our head. And here also feel how is the stretch of your neck moving from the back part to the side of your neck. When you again inhale, you come with your ear towards your shoulder. Exhale, bring your head back towards the middle. Open up your eyes and keep your arms straight, left and right. Engage all muscles on your arms, shoulders relax. Your belly is strong and your tailbone is dropping down towards the ground. Inhale, bring your arms up over your head. Look up towards the ceiling and shoulders are coming away from your ears. Exhale, keep your arms straight. Bring your chin on your chest and reach left and right with your arms. Inhale one more time, up, reach up. Your palms are looking at each other. Look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, your arms are straight. Relax your head. Inhale one more time, up, stretch your whole body up towards the ceiling. Exhale down, chin on your chest, relax your head. Stay there, leave your head relaxed. And now bring your hands behind your back, interlace your 10 fingers behind your back. Shoulder blades are coming towards each other. And with inhale, push your hands away from your body, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale again, relax your head. And move your hands behind your back up towards the ceiling also. Inhale, look up, hands coming away from your body. Exhale again, head towards the ground. Inhale one more time up. And with exhale, you come to forward fold only as much as you can. Relax your head, your upper body towards the ground. And your hands are coming towards the ceiling. Keep your head and neck relaxed. Stay there for three breathings, deep breathing. And the last one. Exhale, with the next inhale, come up to sitting position. Open up your chest, look up. Exhale, relax your arms again. Inhale, reach up with your hands. With exhale, you rotate your upper body to the right side. Left hand is coming on your right knee. Right hand behind you. Inhale, keep your spine straight. Reach up through your head towards the ceiling. And with exhale, rotate your whole upper body. Look over your right shoulder. Your both shoulders are relaxed, far away from your ears. And you are looking behind you. Strong core. And only from the chest part, you are rotating your spine. And then look forward. Leave your left hand on your knee. Inhale, reach up with your arm. And exhale, come to the left side. Stretch your whole right side of your body. Open up your chest. Look forward. Keep your right arm straight and your palm is facing the ground. Inhale, come back to the middle, reach up. Exhale, rotate your upper body to the left side. Right hand on your left knee, left hand behind you. Inhale, keep your back straight, spine straight. With exhale, look over your left shoulder behind you. Hold it here for a while. Feel the spine twist on your body. And then relax your upper body, look forward. Left arm over your head, inhale. Exhale, come to the right side. Reach your left arm more to the right side. Keep stretching the whole left side of your body. Inhale, come back to the middle. Sit down to the middle, stretch your arms up, interlace your 10 fingers and move your palms towards the ceiling. This time bring your arms close towards your ears, stretch your whole upper body. Your hips and knees are relaxed, strong core, keep breathing, hold it here for a while. Actively stretching up towards the ceiling, your arms are straight. With next exhale, you rotate your palms towards your face, you round your back, stretch your arms forward towards me, and your shoulder blades from each other, relax your head. And look at your belly. Inhale, hands up, palms up towards the ceiling. And with exhale, round your back, shoulder blades from each other, arms up parallel towards the ground. Inhale, look up again, arms up. And the last time again, round your back. And the last time, arms up, inhale. With exhale, bring your hands from each other and hands in front of your legs. Inhale, keep your back straight. Now look forward towards me. Keep your neck straight also. And shoulders are coming away from your ears. Relax your shoulders. Your core is strong. And with next exhale, you go only as much as you can forward with your head, step by step. Now when you see that your back is getting ground, you come one step back. You make step back with your hands and you push your chest between your arms to the front. So it's not important to come as low as possible. It's important to feel the stretch in your thighs, outer part of your thighs. Nice straight back and pushing your chest forward towards between your arms. And there where you can with your hands, with every exhale, you can close your eyes, feel the stretch deeply, let everything go in your muscles, relax your muscles. And you can only bend your elbows a little bit to come a little bit lower. Inhale, still reach through your head. Reach through your head to the front and with exhale, bend your elbows. Just 1 millimeter more, come a little bit lower. With next exhale, now round your back, relax your head, your neck. Your forehead is coming towards the ground. Now come with inhale with vertebra by vertebra to sitting position, reach up again. And with exhale, hands back next to your body. We are going to go from crossed leg position to tabletop position. So you can put your blanket to the side or your pillow or what you use by the sitting position and come to tabletop position. Bring your hands under your shoulders and your knees directly under your hips. Spread out all your 10 fingers on your hands. You are pushing your fingertips firmly into your mat. You can feel the whole place of your hand pressed on your strong on your mat. Keep your belly strong, your core is strong, and come into cat-cow position. So you're starting with the lower part of your spine, of your back. With inhale, you're rotating your lower spine, your chest area, and then you're looking forward and up. Exhale from the lower spine, again, around your back. Your belly is coming in towards your spine and relax your head, your neck. One more time, inhale. From the lower back through your chest. And exhale, relax. Your head, your neck, shoulder blades from each other. Inhale, one more time. Look forward and up. And exhale, round your back again. Inhale one more time, forward and up. And exhale, hollow your body. Ribs are coming in. One more time with inhale, arch your back, look forward. And last time, round your back, stay there for a while and push with your hands against your mat. Your belly is coming towards your spine. You are rounded in your back, pushing through your, towards your mat. Hold it here for a while. Head and neck are relaxed. With next inhale, come into neutral position with your spine. And then reach with your right leg to the back. Now make sure that you are not opening your hips up, but you keep your hips closed. Flex your right foot, push your right heel to the back. Hold it here for a while, keep balance, find your balance, and then reach with your left arm to the front. So these are like kind of positions where you might struggle with the balance. And this is the connection of your mind with the body. What I was talking about at the beginning, just try to calm down your mind, first of all, to concentrate on your breathing, and then the balance will come. Hold it here for a while. Keep stretching with your left arm forward with your right foot to the back. And with exhale, bring your knee and elbow together, round your back. Inhale, reach forward and to the back. Exhale, knee and elbow together. Inhale, reach. Exhale, again together. One more time, reach forward and to the back. Hold it here for a while. Strong core, strong body. Exhale, hand and knee on your mat. Switch the sides, left leg to the back. Flex your left foot so your toe tips are coming towards you, pushing your heel to the back, and make sure your leg is in one line with your whole upper body. Your left hip is closed. Reach with your right arm to the front. Hold it here for a while. Again, connect with your breathing. Find the calmness. And then with exhale, knee and elbow together, round your back. Inhale, stretch and reach forward and to the back. Exhale, knee and elbow together. Inhale, reach. Exhale, knee and elbow together. Inhale, one more time, reach. With exhale, round your back and knee and elbow together. Last time, stretch your whole body, your arm and leg. Hold it here for a while. And with exhale, bring your hand and knee on your mat. Sit down on your heels. And relax your hands for a while. So we had a little pressure on our wrist. That's why we shake it out. You can interlace your 10 fingers and to rotate with your wrist to one direction and to the other direction. So in yoga, we are doing a lot of positions on our hands. So it's very important that your wrists are warm. Make sure you don't get any injuries on your wrist. When you feel that it's too big pressure on your wrist, then you better come out from the position. Even when we are going to go to down dog, where much more pressure will come on our wrist. We stay on our heels for a while, and then reach with your arms up, inhale. With exhale, interlace your 10 fingers behind your back, and open up your chest. Inhale, look forward and up. Your palms are touching, and reach with your hands away from your body. Strong core also here. Keep breathing, hold it here for a while. And with exhale, come into forward fold. Bring your forehead on the ground. Hands up towards the ceiling. And slowly come back up. Inhale, open up your chest one more time. Look up and forward. And then relax your arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bring your hands in front of you, come one more time into tabletop position, reach with your right leg to the back, inhale, strong core, and with exhale, push your, bring your right toes on the ground. So your right foot is now on the ground, deep inhale, with exhale, push your weight to the back, and feel a deep stretch on your right leg, on the back part of your right leg. Inhale, come forward with your weight. Exhale, push your weight to the back again. Inhale, forward. And exhale, push yourself to the back. Inhale, again, forward. And push. One more time, come forward. Bring your right leg up. Inhale, reach with your left arm forward. Either you stay here or you can try, if you are good already with your balance, reach with your left hand behind you, hold on your right foot, look forward, with exhale, push your right foot up towards the ceiling. Nice back bend, opening in the left shoulder, hold it here for a while and breathe. And then reach again with your left arm, right foot to the back, exhale again down. Change the side, left leg. Up and back. With exhale, bring your toes on the ground. Deep inhale, exhale, push your weight to the back. Push your left heel to the back. Inhale, come forward. And exhale, again, your hips are coming to the back. Feel a deep stretch in the back part of your left leg. Inhale, forward. Exhale, one more time, push into your toes. Inhale, forward, and exhale, last time. Inhale, come forward, bring your left leg up. Hold your core strong again, left hip side is closed. Reach with your right arm to the front. Look forward in front of you, and hold with your right hand on your left foot. Deep inhale, with exhale, bring your left foot a little bit higher. Open up your chest, your right shoulder. You can feel a nice back bend in your back. And with inhale, reach one more time. And exhale, hands and left knee comes on the ground. We're going to go from this position in our first down dog. So please listen to the instruction. If you know already down dog, make sure you do it step by step so you come into that position with the right holding in your body, in your back, and with your legs. For that, we bring our toes into our mat. And now bring your knees a little bit higher, not higher than your foot ankles. Hold it here over your mat and then push your hips to the back. We are still down. Your belly is touching your thighs and your back gets straight. Relax your head and neck. As the next step, you push your hips up towards the ceiling and you're bringing your legs into straight line. It's not important to keep your legs straight. When you see your back is rounded here, then bend your knees and push your belly towards your thighs. You want to keep your back straight, your shoulders relax, your neck is long, and head is relaxed. So you are welcome to bend your knees just to feel that your back is straight, and then as a last step, you are keeping your legs straight. It's our first down dog. We are going to bend our right knee a little bit more and push your left heel towards the ground. We need to warm up our legs a little bit. And now change the sides, bend your left knee, push your right heel towards the ground. One more time, right knee is bended, left leg straight. And then change the sides again. Bend your left knee, right leg is straight. Head and neck relaxed. Inhale, come on your toe tips. And exhale, both heels are coming towards the ground. Straight back, chest is working towards your thighs. Shoulder area also, nice, relaxed. And then slowly bend your knees, look forward towards your mat, walk step by step with your feet towards your hands. Bring your feet hip distance, and then relax your head and neck, come into forward fold. Also here, you are welcome to bend your knees a little bit. Make sure your belly is tight on your thighs. And now shake out your upper body a little bit. Hold on your elbows. Keep your head and neck relaxed. And shake a little bit left and right. And slowly we will meet in the middle, everyone together. Relax your arms towards the ground, head and neck are relaxed. Strong core, bend your knees a little bit, and now come vertebra by vertebra to standing position. And when you are in the standing position, and rotate your shoulders to the back, come to the beginning of your yoga mat. Bring your big toes together, big toes are touching, and your heels, they can be separated a little bit, just 1 centimeter. Rotate your shoulders to the back and down. Shoulder blades are working towards each other. Your tailbone is dropping down. Strong core, engage your thighs. Also, your thighs are strong. And spread out your 10 toes on the mat. You can feel nice, stable standing position. So even if you play with your weight a little bit to the front, to the back, and to the sides, you can feel how your feet are working and they help you to find the middle of the balance again. This is very, very, very important. By every yoga position to find the balance, it means to be aware of every part of your body. Everything that needs to be engaged is engaged. What needs to be relaxed is relaxed. Mostly it's our face expression. When we are holding the position, we are also holding it with our face. So try to relax your face. Nice smile, relax your cheeks, your forehead, and we're going to start our little fold. So big toes are touching, strong core, opening up your chest, shoulders, relax. Inhale, bring your arms up, look up. With exhale, hands in front of your chest, straight back, bend your knees, coming to forward fold. Inhale, half lift, hands on your shins and your back is in one line parallel towards the ground. Reach with your head forward, your neck is long, and shoulders away from your ears, strong core. Exhale, bring your hands down towards the ground, bend your knees, come lower, place your hands on the ground, and then step with your right foot to the back. Inhale, straight back, look forward, and with exhale, bring your right knee on the ground. Keep your right foot straight. And now try that your fingertips are touching the ground. Be aware of that your left knee is over your foot ankle. Now pushing your left hip side to the back. So you want to square your hips. You're not opening your hips to the right side, but now square them to the shorter edge of your mat. Keep your back straight, look forward. Opening up your chest, pushing with your chest against your left leg. Hold it here for a while. With every exhale, relax your hips a little bit lower. Every tension now in your hip area, let it go. Nice, relax. And then place your right hand on the ground. Inhale, open up your chest. To the left side, both arms are in one line. Exhale, left hand down. Inhale, open up to the right side. Exhale, right hand down on the ground. Open up, left, inhale. Exhale, come down. Inhale, straight back, look forward, and place your right toe tips into your mat. Keep your right leg straight. Hold it here for a while. Bring your weight on your left foot with exhale. Step forward, big toes are touching, and forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Your back is parallel towards the ground. Exhale, forward fold. strong is your core, and then come vertebra by vertebra up to a standing position. Inhale, reach up with your hands. Exhale, hands in front of your chest. Remember our holding in a standing position. Tailbone dropping down, strong core straight, back feet together. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, straight back, bend your knees, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, hands on the ground and stay with your left foot to the back. Your left leg is straight, look forward. Open up your chest. With exhale, place your left knee on the ground. Hold it here, your fingertips are touching the ground. And relax your hips a little bit lower. Nice straight back, and then place your left hand on the ground. Inhale, open up to the right side. Exhale, down. Open up to the left side, inhale. And then again down. One more time to the right side, inhale. Exhale, come down. Inhale, straight back. Bring your left toe tips into your mat. Keep your left leg straight. Exhale, step forward. Big toes are touching, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. And then bend your knees, come with a straight back up again. Inhale. Exhale, hands in front of your chest. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold with a straight back. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, hands on your mat and stay with your right foot to the back. Now you are welcome to bring your right knee again on the mat. Or if you feel you have a little bit more power in your legs and it's okay for you, it's not that exhausting, keep your right knee out of your mat in the air. Keep your right leg straight, and here also we look forward in front of us. We keep our back straight, shoulders away from the ears, and reach up to high lunge. Arms are coming up towards the ceiling and shoulders down, away from your ears. Push your left hip side more to the back. Push your right heel to the back. Keep your right leg straight, strong core, tailbone dropping down. Hold it here for a while, keep breathing. And then come on your right toe tips a little bit higher, push your right heel up. With exhale, push your right heel to the back. One more time up, make sure your left knee is over your left foot ankle and to the back, come down. Again, up, inhale. With exhale, come down. One more time, up on your right toe tips and push your right heel to the back, hands on your mat. Inhale, straight back, look forward, exhale, feet together, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Bend your knees a little bit, come vertebra by vertebra to standing position. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands in front of your chest. Inhale, reach up again. Exhale, come with a straight back, bend your knees into forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, bring your hands on the ground and step with your left foot to the back. So the same situation, you're welcome to bring your knee on the ground or you keep your left leg straight. Inhale, keep your back straight. Strong core, strong thighs, and then reach up towards the high lunge. Shoulders again relaxed. If your knees on the ground and you are coming, we are going now to the next movement. You just keep reaching up and you relax your hips a little bit lower when your knee is on the ground. If you are with a straight leg there, then come up on your left toes and up and down, push your left heel to the back. Come up, inhale. With exhale, left heel to the back. Inhale again, up. And to the back. One more time, up, reach up. Push your heel to the back. Hands next to your foot. And now the change will come. Inhale straight back, look forward. We're going to step with the right foot to the back, coming to plank position. Keep your ribs under your shoulders. You're nice in one line. If this is also a bit difficult, then bring your knees on the ground and make sure you are holding your thighs in one line with your upper body. Or you can stay in one line with your body. Hold it here for a while, keep breathing. Push with your hands against the back. And then we will come everyone on the knees. Your elbows are close to your body. Bring your chest and chin on the ground, look forward. And straighten your back, exhale. We are laying on our belly on the ground. Hands are under your shoulders, your elbows are close to your body. Bring your feet together, engage your muscles. With inhale, open up your chest, coming to cobra. So your back is working here, your neck is long. Hold it here for a while, keep breathing. And you can check if you can leave your hands from your mat. If you really are engaging your back muscles, not supporting your weight with your hands, just your upper body is working. And then slowly with exhale, relax. Bring your forehead on your mat. One more time, deep inhale. With exhale, come up. Cobra. Hold it here for a while. Exhale, relax, forehead on the ground. With next exhale, come one more time up, cobra. Either you stay here or you are welcome to interlace your 10 fingers behind your back. Palms are touching. Open up your chest a little bit more. And then release, bring your hands under your shoulders, forehead on the ground, exhale. Push yourself through your hands on your knees into tabletop position, and we are going to meet for the last time in a down dog. Bring your big toes into your mat, knees a little bit up, hips to the back, exhale. Straight back with next exhale, down dog. Relax your head, your neck, spread out your 10 fingers again and push your weight to the back from your hands on your feet. You are still welcome to pedal it out. When you're still tight in the back part of your legs, you can still play with the movement a little bit. Bend your knees after each other. This is our last down dog for today. So make it your best and enjoy it. With next inhale, you come on your toe tips. Exhale, bring your knees on the ground and sit down on your heels. Bring your arms next to your body. Baby position, child's pose. And then come slowly, vertebra by vertebra, up to sitting position on your heels. And we are going to close our class in a sitting position as we started in the beginning. So for that, we come into tabletop position. Bring your feet up, in cross your calf muscles, and then push yourself to the back. You sit down to the back, keep your legs straight in the front. And before we end up our class, we are going to make a last stretch of the back part of our legs and also of the whole back. So bring your left heel to the longer edge of your mat to the left side. And bend your right knee. Your right foot is on the inner part of your left thigh. Bring your arms up, inhale, shoulders down away from your ears, and push with your right foot against your left thigh. Then rotate your upper body to your left side. Bend your left knee, be straight. Then you are coming forward. Really bend your left knee. It helps you to interlace all your 10 fingers under your foot. And then look forward one more time, straight back. Then with next exhale, you round your back, bring your forehead on your knee. So this is the position where you want to get at the beginning. And as a last step is to keep your left leg straight, pushing your left heel to the front. But make sure that the connection your knee with your forehead stays. And we come vertebra by vertebra to sitting position. Inhale, stretch your arms up. Exhale, hands next to your body. Change the size. Your right leg is straight. Left foot is touching the inner part of your thigh muscles. Inhale, reach up. Push with your foot against your thigh. And then rotate your upper body to the right side. Bend your right knee. Come with a straight back forward. Interlace your 10 fingers. Inhale, keep your body straight, your back is straight. Look forward, reach with your head forward. And then with exhale, round your back, bring your forehead on your knee. Either you stay here or you start to keep your, to stretch your right leg a little bit. Slowly come vertebra by vertebra back to sitting position. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands next to your body. And bend your right knee, coming to cross leg position for our last three breathings. To reflect our practice a little bit, our body. Bring your arms on your knees. Shoulders are coming to the back and down. Shoulder blades together. Close your eyes for a while. Keep your neck nice, long. Reach with your head up towards the ceiling. And then connect with your breathing again. One more time deep, one more time deep. Inhale. Open up your chest. Push your belly button to the front. And then fully exhale, relax your shoulders. Strong core. One more time deep. Inhale. And then full exhale. Take your last deep inhale, reach up to your spine through the crown of your head. And then again, fully exhale. Keep your eyes closed for a while and feel your whole body, your muscles. How does it feel right now after that little yoga session? Feel each part of your body which you stretch. If it's relaxed a little bit more, if there was any difficult part in this practice, that's what you need the most. That's what your body is not get too used to. And you just need to practice, practice, practice. And then slowly open up your eyes. And I thank you very much for joining me, for making this beautiful yoga session with me. I hope that you enjoy it. And in this time, I'm going to give a word again to Annette, and we have a time for questions and answers. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Domi. It was wonderful. How is everyone feeling? I hope you guys are all nicely stretched and relaxed and ready for some Q&A. We actually already have some questions coming in, but if you would like to ask something to Dominika, please feel free to use the Q&A tool right in the bottom of this page. I'm going to just ask you the first question, and that is, how often should I practice to have the best results? What do you think?
So as I mentioned at the beginning, it's individual for everyone. It depends also on your practice, which you have until today already. I don't know if you are new in yoga, doing it for the first time. Definitely don't force yourself to reach any goal in yoga tomorrow or in 1 week or in 1 month. There are some days you feel you want to practice, you need to practice, and then will come some days where your body is just tired. You might get maybe muscle ache from your first practice, and then you just really need to also listen to your body to relax. When your body asks for relaxation and you feel like I want to stay in my bed, I don't want to move, then it's okay. If this happens like for 1 month every day, then it's not okay. So my answer is, depends on your level, and find the great, the best practice for you. What is suitable for your level? And if your body is strong enough to practice every day, you are welcome to practice every day also.
Cool. Thank you so much for the answer. Another question is here. You know, there are so many different types of yoga. What's your favorite type of yoga, Domi, and why?
Yes, you are right. There is many, many different types of yoga. I went through some of them. In my practice, I started with power yoga, where my flexibility was horrible, because in that the time I was doing also martial art, capoeira. So I was used to more like power stuff. I was doing a lot of kicks and like wheels and handstands. So as I came first to yoga, it was very painful for me to stretch anything on my body. But in 8 years, I went through very different styles, and I met a lot of people practicing only one style. They were thinking that this is the best style in the world. My philosophy is every movement which does go to your body is perfect for you. So I never said in my life, now I'm practicing and teaching only hot yoga, because I'm new in Vienna also, and there is not that much time to explore in this time more of it. But I'm always open to every type of yoga. Even, for example, I don't know if you know yin yoga. This is very calm style where you, as I mentioned in the beginning, where you stay in a position for a few minutes and you go to deep stretch in that position. You also use some tools where you put your back on a roll and you are opening your chest a little bit more. So this, as I've seen before only on a video, you saw me like, no way, this is very boring. But then I tried it once and it was so exhausting. Even though I was just laying down in one position 5 minutes, it was very, very difficult. And there I felt also, okay, that's really what I need. My hips were tight, so I needed to open my hips and just to lay down on the back, put my knees to the side, left and right, and to let my body to do its work. So I don't have a favorite style of yoga. As I teach it as I feel it. And when I practice what my body needs. Even I go for jogging, I go to fitness, I go to gym, I go for hike, I do snowboard, so I do a lot of stuff, I love to move. So that's the same in the yoga for me.
Okay, and then brings me actually to another question that is from Denisa Goldirova. Denisa asks, do you practice?
Hello, Denisa, it's my friend.
Do you practice yoga every day yourself during this quarantine period? Which time of the day do you prefer for exercise?
Yes, of course, I practice almost every day because now it's a lot of time for that. And especially because now people working in office as me, I'm in home office, so sitting behind my computer like 8 hours is really distracting you. When I go to office, at least I take that away with the subway, or I walk to the bus station, and I'm moving in our company around. So yeah, I feel it for me that I have to practice every day. So every time I get the chance, even through the lunch break, I take 15 minutes to stretch my body a little bit, or I go for jogging when the weather is nice. Now we had nice sunny days, so I also moved a little bit outside. I went for jogging, and I prefer to practice in the evening. In the evening, I feel very relaxed, and it's easier to fall asleep for me. And yes, that's my practice during the day.
That's great. Maybe we have time for one last question, and that would be, actually, what is the best way to combine another sport and yoga? Is it better to do for like a warm up or cool down, or should I do it another day?
If I understood right your question, you are already doing other type of sport and you would like to combine it with the yoga. Depends also on the style of yoga you are doing. There are styles where you go deeper in a stretch. If this is your aim, you want to stretch your body a little bit more, it's definitely good after you do your sport, when your body is warm. So that's why I also allow my hot yoga classes in 37 degrees, because it allows you to gain a bit bigger flexibility. When your whole body is warm, your muscles are warm, then you come a little bit deeper into your stretch. So if you want to combine it with other sports, the best is to do it for a few minutes after you do your sport. Next day, probably when you have muscle ache, it's going to be a bit difficult because your muscles are tight, but maybe find also there a little time for a stretch. Never force yourself into stretch so you don't get any pain, or get any problems with your muscles and in your ankles.
Great. Hey, thank you, Dominika, for being with us today. Thank you for a wonderful yoga class and for answering all those questions. Thank you also everyone else who has been with us today. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you feel relaxed. And I would also like to invite you to check out our other upcoming webinars and maybe share your experience via social media. And I hope to see you again very soon. So thank you very much. Have a lovely day.
Yes. What a great experience. Bye.
Bye.